Francis, talk to me about the technology that's gone into this latest iteration of sequencing tech. What have you actually done to update it?
This is a huge step forward in our technology platform. We really redid every part of the sequencer. So we've invented an entire new chemistry called X-Leap SBS. We invented a whole new optic system, including the glass we needed for the lens. This didn't exist anywhere in the world, so we had to invent new glass to use in the lens. We've invented a whole new data path with high performance compute on the machine itself. So really, this has been just a ground up redo of our sequencer platform so that we could get a major step change in terms of performance and really bring the price of sequencing, of genomic sequencing, you know, down for the market. We're also able to make this more sustainable product and eliminate the need for the cold chain. So before that, you needed dry ice to ship the reagents to run the machine to the labs around the world. And you don't need that anymore. And so this makes a sequencer accessible to countries around the world that don't have access to cold chain. So it's a big step forward in accessibility.
Francis, your ultimate goal is a $100 genome. You're at $200. Is this just you playing it safe?
You know, our path, our strategy as a company has been to drive the prices down. And we've done that over the course of many years. When we first launched our sequencer in 2007, the price to sequence one genome was $150,000. And that was a breakthrough price in the market. We've gone from $150,000 a genome to $200 a genome in that time frame, 2007 till today. So greater than 99% price reduction. And we're not stopping there. We believe to make genomics accessible to everybody and have the difference in healthcare that it can, we need to keep going.
Does this once again make you the market leader, the tech leader? Do you leapfrog back to that position of leadership?
You know, we really believe that in order to move the market forward, we need to drive more innovation to make sequencing accessible. At this point, we do believe that our products represent the best sort of value proposition to customers in terms of performance and price. But look, the reality is we're very early in this market, right? If you think about the market opportunity in front of us, we still have largely untapped the medical need for genomic sequencing. So the vast majority of the market is still in front of us. A lot of innovation to do to really open up the markets as we think they need to be.
I want to ask you about the reality of this for your customers. We're talking about labs, right? Complicated, sophisticated labs. You're talking $200 genome, but it's an expensive cost for them. What have your pre-orders been like? What has the initial interest from your customer base been?
Well, the early response has been phenomenal. You know, we gave a sneak peek to a few customers before I did the announcement this morning, and every single one of them pre-ordered. So we're at the stage now where we're taking orders. We ship the instrument in Q1 of next year, so a few months from now, and we're going to be taking orders between now and then. The response has been strong on a number of fronts. People really appreciate the price reduction. People love the sustainability features, so reducing the waste and the plastic. And people, we had a couple of customers come to us in tears about the fact that you no longer need a cold chain. So this product is now available in parts of the world that just didn't have access to high throughput sequencing.
Francis, your $7 billion deal for Grail was vetoed by the European Union. At this stage of the process, do you give up?
You know, the deal for Grail is an important one because, as you know, what we invented with Grail was a blood test that can find 50 types of cancer across stages. That's life-changing because we know that 10 million people a year die of cancer. And we also know that if you catch a cancer early, your odds of surviving are so much higher than if you catch it late. Now, 70% of the people who die from cancers that are caught at late stages. So by doing the blood test, by rolling out Grail's blood test more broadly, you know, we believe that that has the potential to save many lives around the world. And we can roll it out more broadly than Grail could on its own. So it's important. We're going to continue through the process to see if we can win on appeal with the European Commission.